Hey guys, Michael here, founder and CEO of Gorelo. We're just going to do a quick dive into the RMM section of Gorelo. So what you're looking at here is the asset list. So if I blow out the left-hand menu here, you can see under the RMM section, we have assets, scripts, policies, and uptime. Right now, we're looking at assets. These are your views on the left-hand side. You can create whatever views you want here to filter the assets over on the right. These views can be shared amongst your team, so you're all seeing the exact same thing. Over on the right here, these are all the assets. You can show and hide different columns. You can filter, you can generate a CSV and so forth. So from here, we're just gonna dig into one of these assets. We're gonna click on this virtual machine here, and we've now landed on the asset detail page. So up the top, this is the status, the host name, the last logged on user. If it happens to be an Entra ID joined device, we will show the full UPN, makes it a little bit easier to find that particular asset. The client, the location, and we have a description field here. So the handy thing about this description field, you can put whatever information in there you want, and it's actually indexed in search. So if you go to search for this at a later date, you can find the associated asset just like this. In the middle here, this is the summary of the asset. This is different software and hardware details. And over on the right, we've got OS uptime, a serial number, warranty expiration date. So we integrate with Dell and Lenovo warranty APIs and we pull those in automatically. You can override these for other vendors and anything like that. Antivirus status, hook into the Windows Security Center. As long as your AV supports that, we can monitor it. OS status, this is patch management for Windows itself. There's nothing outstanding here. There is a security update which was released today. So this is Microsoft Defender. You'll get a couple of those per day and they'll be automatically installed. Firewall status, just the three Windows firewalls. Any disabled, you can re-enable them here. App status, this is Windows patch management or third-party patch management powered by Winget. You can see I am looking to roll out Microsoft Teams and it is already up to date here. So up the top right-hand corner here, this is our remote access tool. It's called Gorelo Connect. So if you click on here, it'll actually launch that Gorelo Connect session. You can jump into a computer. Let me just move that a little bit. You can click like the start icon, file explorer, things like that. And you can work remotely onto that on that actual machine. Over here behind the drop-down menu, we have file explorer. So this is remote background file explorer. So without interrupting the user, you can jump into the back end and you can move files around. You can pull down logs, things like that. This little icon here, this is our related icon. So this allows you to relate this asset to other assets, contacts, documents, and even upload attachments and things like that. So in this case, maybe this asset's related to my MacBook here. In this case, I can build out that relationship. This is two-way. So if I click on this asset here and go to its related items, you can see it does have that two-way relationship back to where I just was. So this allows you to build out a relationship with all those different pieces of the puzzle across all your clients and in different areas. Three-dot menu has a few different options here. This is our integration with slide backups. So you can actually see there was a successful backup here. And you can see that there is a boot verification and screenshots along the way. Pretty handy. In the middle here, this is the timeline. This shows you everything that has gone on with this particular asset, who did what, if any alerts were generated, and things like that in chronological order. On the left-hand side, extra system info. We have a CLI. From here, you can run a script that you've pinned, so such as showing logged in users. You can also use AI assistance to generate a PowerShell script to show all running services. If you're not sure of what the PowerShell command is, you can use AI for that. You can switch to command prompt, you can run as user and a few other options there. This is a live call to see all the processes on the machine, filter them, kill them, start them. Same goes for services. Disks. With disks, we actually do pull the BitLocker recovery key and we do cache that offline. So if this computer dies, you will have that key here. Apps, we're pulling all the apps on the machine and we're actually cross-checking that with Winget. If it's Winget capable, we will show you the available version and even options to uninstall. You can also kick off an install from our Winget catalog. So if I wanted to install Edge or Adobe, things like that, I can do it from here. You can also just grab the Winget app ID and throw it straight in here and we'll kick off an install for that as well. Now, antivirus is just hooks into the Windows Security Center. In this case, it's Defender, it's enabled and it's up to date. OS updates, these are just different patches that are installed. Policy is how we actually roll out different checks, plugins, scripts, things like that at scale. And the way we do it is based on tags or the way we categorize things. So we use tags, are a few baked in, but you can also create your own custom tags in the back end. So if you go down to asset tags here, let's actually edit this Veeam one. In this case, I'm automatically applying the Veeam tag if installed apps contains Veeam, and it'll automatically remove it if installed apps does not actually contain Veeam. So in this way, you can automatically apply these tags and automatically remove them based on different properties on that machine. You can then apply your checks, plugins, and scripts to different groups. Maybe you want an event log check to roll out to every single asset that gets tagged as Veeam. When it comes to those tags, you can not only just roll out policies via them, but you can actually create your own views back here using those tags. So you can create a new view and you could say include this particular tag, exclude this particular tag as well. So a cool way to actually make a customized view here. Another area that we use asset tags is in the billing section. So you can actually build out a contract and automate all of your billing based on a certain tag. So maybe you're looking to automatically bill for Huntress, automatically bill for Sophos or something along those lines. You can actually go to your contract and then on the line item, you could tie that quantity dynamically to an asset tag, whether it's a built-in tag or it's a custom tag you've created. In this case, I'm going to tie it to Windows Workstation. There's three different tags or three different assets here. I'm going to click apply and I'm even going to list the host names of those assets on the invoice. So when I roll out a new agent, this will go from 3 to 4. If I uninstall the agent, it'll go from 4 down to 3. And this is all automated. So heading back over to the RMM side of things, we can have a quick look at policies. So policies is how you actually distribute all the different checks, plugins, and scripts at scale to all your computers. The way we do that is you create a policy, you target certain tags, and then you add your checks, plugins, and scripts there. When it comes to checks, plugins, and scripts, everything you'd expect. Disk usage, event log, CPU memory, ping. When it comes to plugins, a little bit more advanced. Maybe your Tray app, app management, remote access software, Huntress, Windows patch management, things like that. And lastly, anything you can't do natively with what we have, you can use a script. Example, installing action one. You could run it continuously on a schedule, run it once at logon, or even at startup. When it comes to scripting, it's very powerful. So scripting in the back end here, you might have a script to, let's say, set a local admin password. In Gorelo, you can create a PowerShell script, you could change it to bash, command line, set a timeout, run as user. You can even add variables. If you leave a variable blank here, it can be requested at runtime for your technicians to fill in. There are a lot of other variables in Gorelo, from client-based ones through to custom asset fields. You can also use the concept of Gorelo Action. Gorelo Action can read and write from different fields. It can also generate alerts. So in this circumstance, I've created a local admin password script, essentially LAPS, but inside Gorelo. It will run every day at, let's say, midday, and it'll automatically rotate the local admin password. And then it'll write it back to one of these custom fields for your techs to use. That way you have a unique local admin password on every single computer out there, automatically being rotated. Next along, let's have a quick look at uptime. So uptime is to monitor the uptime of internet connections and websites. So an internet connection would be via ICMP. You're essentially pinging that IP address of their internet connection and you're receiving a success back. We're checking it every minute. We're doing 2 more rechecks and we're doing it from the Sydney region. We also have Seattle and a UK one coming in the very near future. You can do the same for websites. In this case, you're checking a website is truly online. With all of these different things that we're monitoring, they all feed into our alert section. So here you can see there's views on the left. You can create your own views. You can share them with your team. And these are the filtered alerts over on the right-hand side. So you can see it's in chronological order. The most recent was from 8 minutes ago, 9 hours, 1 day, and so forth. These are the severity levels, warning, critical, error. And you can actually see a number next to it. This is a stack of alerts. So if the exact same thing generates the exact same alert, we will stack them up so it's easy to see. We're not going to take up the whole screen here with 100 different alerts. We'll stack it under this one area. You can see the host name here, the status of this asset, a few quick actions, and then the full alert. Here's the client. Here's the ability to create a ticket. And you can even just dismiss an alert. Dismissing it is just that one instance of the alert. It is not muting it. It is not killing it or anything like that. If it triggers again, you'll have the alert flow back through. So that's a quick run through of the RMM. There's a lot more complexity going on there, but I'll save that for a future video. Thank you.